Sacred Lexus of the Penobscot Nation was the turn of the century sports sensation. The first to make the Holy Cross Sports Hall, the nation's best college player of them all. In his last year there, he hit 444. God gave him the talent to do even more. Did he smash 600-foot homers? Could that be true? Lewis Sock Alexis, a legend through and through. In the dead ball era, he belted titanic blows beyond the baseball field, through fourth-story windows. He threw strikes to the catcher 400 feet away. If runners tried to score, Lewis made them pay. Lewis Sock Alexis of the Penobscot Nation was the turn of the century sports sensation. The first to make the Holy Cross Sports Hall, the nation's best college player of them all. Not the first Native American to make it to the majors, but the first to headline the nation's sports pages. He blazed like a comet across the baseball sky. To Hall of Famers, Lewis was a marvel to the eye. The immortal John McGraw surely spoke the truth. He could have been better than Ty Cobb, Wagner, or Babe Ruth. He not only inspired, he was Frank Merriwell. Lewis was myth come to life until he fell. For though faster than the fleet-footed cop, Lewis couldn't outrun himself or baseball's mob. Fans hounded him with war whoops in every city. The beating of their drums left him no pity. Lewis Sock Alexis of the Penobscot Nation was the turn of the century sports sensation. The first to make the Holy Cross Sports Hall, the nation's best college player of them all. Blacks were barred, but they had a league of their own. Lewis played in the white man's majors all alone. How many war whoops pierced his heart? How many cartoons tore him apart? Though there was much wonder in Lewis's life, the pain inside and out cut him like a knife. Soon this cyclone of fame whirled him out with the rain. Back to the land he loved, he died in the woods of Maine. Many ask what might have been when speaking of his name. Lewis lives in his people's heart, the true Hall of Fame.